In this class, we will see to determine the transfer function of a complicated closed loop system. Determination of transfer function of closed loop system. There are two methods. The first one is block diagram reduction, and second is signal flow graph method. So there are two methods. One is block diagram reduction techniques, and second is the flow graph, the signal flow graph method. Now, first we will see block diagram reduction method. Now, see here. We will assume that in this one there are certain rules. Now see here, the rules are: if suppose the input is X and there are the blocks, that is G1 and G2 are connected in this fashion, and the output is suppose Y. Now see here, this is our input G, input X. The gain of the block is G1, another gain of the blocks is G2, and then we have the output Y. Now see here, at this point, that means the output of the G1 is X multiplied by G1. That means X into G1 is the input to the block G2. So we have Y, it is equals to X multiplied by G1 into G2. So this we can reduce like this one. We will have here the one block, which is the multiplication of the 2-1, and here it is the input is X, and here it is the Y. Again, Y becomes X multiplied by G1 into G2, because X is the input to the block, that is G1 and G2. So X multiplied by gain, that is G1 into G2, it is equals to our output, that is Y. So that means Y, it is equals to X into G1 G2. Now see here, this is our original block diagram. Block diagrams is given. And these block diagrams we are converting into the single block. So that means we are converting this G1 and G2 that we are multiplying. And see here, the rule is that output should not change. Here, when the two blocks are separated, connected separately, our output Y is X into G1 into G2. Our output is X multiplied by G1 into G2. Now, when we converting these blocks into the one blocks, these two block into the one block, my output should not change. Whatever the output of the system, that should not change. This is our output of the system that we have derived it from the our original block diagram, from our original blocks. Now, our aim is to keep the same output, and we have to modify the system. How we can modify? We will put here X as the input as it is, because X is the input given. Now these are the gains, that is G1 and G2. So we will consider G1 and G2 as a single gain in a single block. So that means we are multiplying these two one, and then we get the Y output. It is equals to X multiplied by the gain of the block. Gain of the block is G1 multiplied by G2. So that means when the two blocks are connected in a series, or it is called as the cascaded connection. Cascaded connections means the output of the first block is given as an input to the second blocks. That means these two are connected in series or these two are connected in cascaded form. In that case, we can directly multiply the gain of the blocks. Here the two blocks are given. There may be 3, 4, 5 like this one. There may be G1, G2, G3 may be connected in series. Then here will be the G1, G2 and G3. G1, G2 and G3. So first you find out how many blocks are connected in the series and you just multiply that blocks gain, and instead of that number of blocks you can put there is a single block with the gain of G1, G2, G3 and so on and so on. So our output will remain same. It is equal to x into G1, G2, G3 and so on. Here the two blocks are there. So our output is x into G1, G2. So this is our first rule. Now see here in the second rule. Now see here, if suppose this is my block diagram, original block diagram. Here is the G1 and here is the G2 and these two are connected to a one. Let's say this is plus, this is plus. These signs I am assuming maybe negative, maybe positive, maybe one negative, one positive, one negative, like this one. And now first we have to find out the y. Now see here, this is the x and x is the input. This is the point common from where this x is connected to the G1 as well as this x is connected to the G2. So that means here the input is x1, here the input is also x. Here in both the cases, the input in both the blocks, the inputs are xx. So what is the output here? X into G1 and here x into G2. Now these two inputs are given to the one summing points. What is the sign here? Plus. What is the sign here? Plus. So that means we get here x into G1 plus x into G2. These two output gets added here. So we can write down y it is equal to x multiplied by G1 plus G2. Now see here, when these type of connections or when these type of blocks are given, so that means these two blocks are connected in parallel. Here in the first case, these two blocks are connected in series and here the two blocks are connected in parallel. Now see here, when the parallel, how to identify the parallel connection? The input of the blocks, those are connected in parallel must have the same input. So that means the block G1 and the block G2 are having the same input. And the output of the two blocks must get added, here the sign is plus, here is the sign is plus. So we have considered both the outputs positive. But if this is positive and this is negative, then this becomes x multiplied by G1 minus G2. So find out, first be confirm what is the sign given over there, what is the sign given at the output. If one is positive, one is negative, then there is a subtraction. If both are positive, then there is a addition. If both are negative, then again that we have the common minus signs and these two gets becomes added. Now see here, x is the input to the G1, x is the input to the G2. That means both the blocks are having the same inputs. Their outputs gets added. So we can say that it is a parallel connection. And in the parallel connections, the output is the sum of the two block gains multiplied by their input. The gains, there is an addition of the two gain and multiply it by their input, that is x. So y is the x multiplied by sum of the gain, that is G1 plus G2. Now this block, these blocks we can convert like this one. Here we have the inputs will remain same. The gain, that is G1 plus G2, and then we have the output, that is y. Y it is equal to x multiplied by gain of the block. Gain of the block is what? G1 plus G2. Now see here, in both the cases our output remains same. Y it is equal to x into g1 plus g2, and here y it is equal to x into g1 plus g2. So that means this block, this complete blocks, we can convert into this simple block. Our aim is to convert the system into the simple blocks. So now g1 and g2 are connected in parallel, so we can simply add them. If the both the signs are positive, then this becomes g1 plus g2. If this is positive, this is negative, then this becomes g1 minus g2, like this one. So to be careful, what is the sign of the g1 and g2, that particular sign you have to put there with the g1 and the g2. Here both the signs are positive, so we have added them simply. That is g1 plus g2 multiplied by gain. So we get the y it is equal to x into g1 plus g2. So when the two blocks are connected in parallel, that we can convert into simple blocks with their addition, with their algebraic sum. So this is the second rule. Now we will see the third rule. Now see here, if suppose we have a summing point, let's say this is x, this is y, and this is z. Let's say this is negative, this is positive, and this is positive. And here we have the output, that is c. Let's say the output is c. Now see here, x is positive, y is positive, and z is negative. So that means output becomes x plus y minus z. It is equal to x plus y minus z. This is our output of the summing point. Now this we can redraw like this one. This is plus, and this we can have, this is plus. So this is y, this is x, and then again we will take this is plus and this is minus, and here is the z, and then here we have the c. Now see here, what is c is coming. This is x and this is y. So the output of the summing point is x plus y. So that means it is positive and this is negative. So x plus y minus z. Again, these two outputs are same. Now see here, again we can have the another combination. Let's say this is x. Okay, and here we will consider minus z. And then we will have this is plus, and here it is plus y. Now see what is c is coming. So this is x is positive and z is negative. So that means here is x minus z plus y. This is positive, this is negative. So that means x minus z as it is plus y. So c we can write down, it is x plus y minus z. So that means we can place anyone at the any places. This is x plus y, that we can take it first. Okay, this is the simple algebraic addition subtraction. So here is our first input, that is x. So we have taken xx at the first, this one. We are assuming that x is our reference, so that we have not changed the x, this one. Okay, and these are the coming from somewhere from the in a system. So this is positive, so first we have taken these two input first, and then the z. Again we are getting the same output. For simplicity, again that we have the another combination, that is x minus z. So that is our output is x minus z, and we have added y there. So x minus z plus y, or we can write down x plus y minus z. So these two outputs are equivalent with our first case. So that means if the two blocks are given, or the two summing points are given, so we can combine them with the one, or if the three inputs are given at one summing points, we can separate it out with the two. we can separate it out with the two. Here is the two inputs and here is again two inputs. Here is the two inputs and again here is the two inputs to the second summing point. So anyway, we can do anyone. If the two separate inputs or the summing points are given, then we can. Or another way is that if suppose these two types of summing points are given, if these two are given, then we can convert it into this type. If this is the block diagrams is given, or the this is the conditions is given, that is x, y and z are given, okay, or this we can convert into this type. That means z we can take it here, x as it is here, and we can shift this y here, we can shift this y here. So anything is possible, anything is possible. Simply that we have to add, simply that we have to add or subtract algebraically, algebraically. So simple way, we can have a this type of law, that we can have x plus y first and then z, or we can have x minus z first and then y, and then between these two that we can interchange. Or if the three are given, then we can convert it into two blocks into this type, or these three we can convert into this type. If suppose these two blocks are given or the two summing points are given, then we can convert, or we can convert it into these two types of summing points. So this is the condition, this is the conditions by which we can convert the three inputs connected at the summing points, then we can convert it into two. Or if the two summing points are given with the inputs, then we can replace their input positions, and again we will have the same output as that of your previous conditions. So this is the way by which we can convert the summing points, or we can change the position of the summing points, or we can change the position, the input positions of the summing points. So this is our third rule, this is our third rule. Now the fourth rule, the fourth rule. Now moving here, first I will write down the condition. Moving summing point after a block. Moving summing point after a block. After a block. Now see here, we have original diagram is like this one. This is plus, that is x. Okay. And then here we have the gain, that is g, and here we have the output, that is y. And let's say here the input is, this is positive, this is negative. Let's say the input is z, input is z. So what is the output here? That is x is positive and z is negative, so that means it is x minus z. And here x minus z is the input to the block g, so our y, it is equals to x minus z multiplied by g, multiplied by g. Or we can write down y, it is equals to x into g minus z into g, x minus g into z into g. So this is our original block diagram, this is our original blocks are given. Here the input is x, here the input is minus z, and they are added at a summing point. So we have the output x minus z, and then we have the block of again g. So our output y, it is equals to x minus z into g. So if we solve this one, then we get y, it is equals to x into g and minus z into g, minus z into g. And x and z, these are the two inputs to the summing points. X is reference and y, z is coming from somewhere in the system. Let us assume that that is z input. So this is the block diagram that we have. Now what is our purpose? Moving summing point after a block. Moving summing point after a block. This is the summing point and this is a block. So that means we are interchanging the position of the summing point and the block. So that means we are moving this summing point here. We are moving summing point here. We are moving the summing point this one. Now see here, what will happens now? We will first interchange the position. We will first interchange the position. Now here the first is the g1. Here first is the g1. Then we have the summing point. Then we have the summing point, and then we have the output y. Now see here, what is the our reference input to the summing point? That is x. And what is the another input? That is minus z, plus x and minus z. So what happens here? What we will do here? This is the g. So we have to apply some input here. So we will apply here the x as it is. That is our reference input. And here we will apply minus z. This is minus z input. Now see here, what is the output here? X into g1. So what is the output here? If we after interchanging, it becomes x, this is positive, this is negative. So this becomes x into g1 minus z. Now see here, it is x into g1 minus z. That is my final output. And what output I required here? X into g minus z into g. So what is the output here? X into g1 minus z. That means to the second terms. Here is the only z, and here is the z into g. That means in this ones, in the output, g1 terms is missing. So what happens here? I will put another block here, which is equivalent to the g1, and I will apply the input here z. So what is the output here? z into g1. So this is x into g1 and this is z into g1. So this becomes x into g1 minus z into g1. So that means if we are moving a summing point after a block, then we have to put one block equivalent to g1 into the second input. This is our first input, this is our second input. So in the second inputs that we have to add the block in that line, we have to add the block equivalent to the blocks we are shifting. So here we are shifting the block that is equivalent to g1. So we will add the g1 value into the second input. Then only our output will remain same. Our purpose is we are modifying the block diagram, but our output should not change. Our primary aim is that my output remains same. I will modify the diagram, okay, but I will not change my final output of the system. My final output of the system is x into g1 minus g into z. So I will keep this ones. Here I will apply x, here I will apply g, and then it gets added. Now we will see, this is fourth. Now we will see the another rule, that is fifth. Fifth rules will be moving block ahead a summing point. Moving a block ahead a summing point. Now see here, our block diagrams, the first one that we will have here, this is plus, this is minus, let's say this is x and this is z, and again here we have the block g1, and here we have y. It is equal to what? Again this is x minus z, because x is positive, z is negative, so here is x minus z, and it gets multiplied with g1, so this becomes x minus z into g1. So y, it is equal to x into g1 minus z into g1. This we have. Now we are moving this block ahead a summing point. So now here we will apply g1 will be there, and these inputs will remain same, that is x. And then here we will have the summing points. Here this will be positive, and the second input, that is, let us say this is z. And now find out what is my output. What is my output? We have interchanged the position. We have interchanged the position. We are moving this block here. We are moving this block here. G1 and this one. इसमें क्या किया था, सॉरी मूविंग अ समिंग पॉइंट आफ्टर ए ब्लॉक, मूविंग अ ब्लॉक सॉरी मूविंग अ ओके ओके सॉरी दिस इज नॉट देयर अगेन इट इज कमिंग सेम सो दिस इज फिफ्थ मूविंग मूविंग अ समिंग पॉइंट before a block, moving a summing point before a block. Okay, so now let us say we have this diagram. This is G1, here is the input is x, here this is positive, this is negative, and here we have the output y, and here the input is z. Now this becomes x into g1, so this is x into g1 minus z, so this becomes x into g1 minus z, so this is our output. Now we will move the summing point before a block. Summing points we will move ahead a block. Now our diagrams will be like this one. This is x, this is plus, this is minus, and here is the input is z. And then we have the block g1, and here we have the output. Now see here it is x minus z, and here we get y, it is equals to x minus z into g. So we have y, it is equals to x into g1 minus x z into g. y it is equals to x into g and minus z into g. So this output we get. So what is happening? x into g1, it's okay. x into g1 is okay, but what happens here? here is the only z, but what is here? z into g1. So that means here the g1 is extra term. So what happens here? Instead of these ones, we will put here the one more block, and here we will apply the z, and here we will put the reciprocal of the blocks which are moving. So what is the gain of the block? That is g1. So we will put here 1 by g1. So what is here? z divided by g1. So what is the output here? x minus z divided by g1. So what is here? z divided by g1 multiplied by g1. So what is here? x into g1 and z divided by g1 multiplied by g1. g1 gets cancelled, so we have y, it is equals to x into g1 minus z. So these two outputs are again same. Our aim is to keep the output constant. To keep the output constant. So what is my output? That is x into g1 into z. So here we must have the same output, that is x into g1 multiplied by z. So what happens here? The these summing points, we are moving ahead a block. We are moving ahead a block. So what happens here? What is the gain of the blocks? That gain of the blocks we will put, that is 1 by g1 into the another input. Into the another input. X will remains as it is, but in the another inputs which we are moving, here is the z. So into that inputs we will add another block which is equivalent to the 1 by g1. Which is equivalent to the 1 by g1. So here the output of these blocks is z divided by g1, because z is the input, input multiplied by gain. So z divided by g1 is the output of this block. It is given to the summing point. So output of the summing point is x minus z divided by g1. Z divided by g1, which is the input to the g1. So x minus z divided by g1 into g1. So if we expand this one, then we get x into g1, and this g1 gets cancelled. So here is only z. So we will have the same output which is of that first system. First system. So this is the output of the system. This is the output of the system, and both the outputs are identical. So that means if this is the system and you want to convert it into this format, so then we have to add a one block which is 1 by g1 or 1 by g1, which blocks we are moving, the equivalent of this one, that is 1 by g1, this block that we have to add into the another input, that we have to add into the another input. So this is our fifth rule. So this is our fifth rule. Then the sixth rule. Then the sixth rule. Moving a block ahead a takeoff point. Ahead of takeoff point. If suppose this is our input. This is our input, that is x. Here is the block, that is g1. And here we have the output, that is y. And here from this one the takeoff point is there, and here again we have the output, that is y1, that is y1. Now see here, after this ones, here we get x into g1, x into g1, that is x is the input multiplied by gain, that is our output of this block, that is x into g1. So that means y, it is equals to x into g1, x into g1, and the same output that we are getting here. So that means it is x into g1, that means it is x into g1. So that means y and y1, here the takeoff points is taken from the feedback, no? So we will have some output over here. So we have some output over here. So the output, whatever the output at the takeoff points, that same output we are getting here, that is x into g1, x into g1, and our output of the system becomes y, it is equals to x into g1, x into g1. Now what happens here? We are moving the block ahead a takeoff point, ahead a takeoff points. So that means we have this type of system. Now this is g1, and here we get y, and here we have the takeoff points, and here we have the output, here we have the output. Here the input is x, input is x. So what is the output here? X multiplied by g1. So that means x into g1 is the output, x into g1 is the output. And what is the output here? What is the output here? Only x, only x. But what is the second output? That is y1, that is y1, it is equals to x. What we required here? X into g1. So that means we have to put another block here which is equivalent to the g1, and then we will get here y1. So y1, it is equals to again x into g1, again x into g1, into the feedback path, into the feedback path. Whatever the gain of the system, that is g1, the same gain that we have to put it into the feedback path, so that we will have the same output as that of your original system. This is our original system. So we will moving these takeoff points ahead a block, ahead a block. So that means we will have the same system, we will have the same output over there. Now in the next rule that we will see, in the next rule that we will see, the next rule, that is the seventh, that is the 7th. Moving echo point after a block. Now see here, this is our system. This is G1, here is the Y, here is the X, here is the takeoff point, and here is the Y1, it is equal to X, because the same output that we are getting here, whatever the input is there, this X is again applied at a G1, so here it becomes X into G1. Because X is the input, gain is the G1, so output it is equal to gain multiplied by input. Input is X, gain is G1, so X into G1 is our output. Now we are moving a takeoff point after a block like this one. So what happens here? Here is the G1, here is the input is X, and then here we have the output Y. Y it is equal to what? X into G1. X into G1. And here the takeoff point. Here the takeoff points. And here we have the another output. Another output. What is here? Y1. It is equal to what? X into G1. X into G1. But what is we required? Only X. So what happens here? We will put another block which is 1 by G1. So here is X into G1 is the input here. So what is output here? X only. X into G1 divided by G1. G1 gets cancelled. So what is remaining only? X. What is remaining only? X. So Y it is equal to X. So these are the some of the rules which we required, or we may help. It may help us to solve the complicated block diagram. So there are certain rules, 7 rules are there. First is the cascaded or the series blocks that we can reduce into the one block. When the two blocks are connected in the parallel, again that we can reduce in the single block. Then the if the summing points is having the 3 inputs, we can convert it into 2 summing points. Okay, if the 2 summing points are given, we can interchange their positions, or 2 summing points we can convert it into the single summing points also. Then we can move the summing points after a block, or we can move the summing points before a block like this one, and we can move the takeoff points after a block, or we can move the takeoff points after a block like this one. So there are these seven rules are there, and it help us to solve the complicated block diagram.